Obviously, judging by that opening, you're now expecting me to say that the Hyundai Getz is a fantastic, sporty, youthful and practical car. Nope, that'd be a Suzuki Swift. The Hyundai Getz, on the other hand, is none of those things, and it's quite honestly the worst car I've ever driven. So, how does it look? Well, let's see, it's pretty ordinary really. The slightly pretty front end is ruined by the Hitler with a ruler back end, the ridiculous tail lamps and the pathetic plastic trim bumpers. Side on, it's not too bad, and the front end, as mentioned, is fairly nice. Fog lamps are included, and it's a nice touch. Unfortunately, you do get crummy plastic wheels. No alloys on the basic model. The plastic parts of the bodywork are just disappointing, really. Inside, there's a 1.4-litre sewing engine developing negative 70 kilowatt at 12,000 RPM, which looks like my grandmother's sewing machine. Inside the cockpit, you get a terrible wheel with shoddy buttons and an average aircon unit. But there is a nice surprise in the radio, which comes with Bluetooth, USB and auxiliary in functions. Impressive, if you feel like charging your iPod or plugging in a dedicated tuner. However, the Bluetooth function does really pose quite a question. It's mainly for businessmen who want a cheap, hands-free system. You gotta ask yourself, what kind of self-respecting businessman drives a Hyundai Getz? Other than that, you get a $4.99 bargain bin for a glove box, cheaply fitted interior, and my pet peeve, acres of painted metal, a surefire sign of cheap construction. Surprisingly, you do actually get ESP, which helps keep the car in check, but to be honest, this car needs it because it's so badly balanced on the road. Despite its small size, I did not feel safe in this car. In fact, it felt rather wallowy and ready to tip at pretty much any corner. Once going round a roundabout, the ESP light came on and the car went up on three wheels. There's lap sash belts for all though, and you do get four airbags, but that's considerably less compared to its competition in the form of the Mazda 2, Honda Jazz, Suzuki Swift and others. So up to this point, it's not looking particularly good. We seem to have a cheaply assembled, boring old box with no-go and dubious safety features. But what about the real world? Well, here's my friend Alex, and we're going to do a serious road test. Come on, Alex, round the block then.
Here we go, let's see what she'll do.
Let's see what she'll do. Okay.
What do you want to say? Just. Right, here we go. We'll see what she does when we put the foot right down. That's 50. Yep. Still 50. 50. 60! 60! 60! Oh, corner. Oh, yeah. I think handles like my ex-wife. Fucking hell. Okay, we're going to make a tight turn here. What the f*** was that? What was that in the back? What the hell was that in the back?
What about that thing?
What's that?
I don't know.
The net?
No. The floor.
Oh. God.
Oh, God.
It's supposed to come out like that. Oh, God.
Well, that's well secured. Jesus Christ, alright, come on then. Better get out of here.
Now obviously, because this car is a rental, we should take care of it, and we did.
Okay, just reverse out.
Oh, God, what the
Jesus,
hell was that?
What was that? That was the gearbox not engaging. Oh my God.
Far out.
Oh, this is the worst thing I've ever driven.
Yeah. 10 point. 10 point. 10 point.
And pull up to the roundabout here. Oh, telecom band. What have you broken now, you f***? Coming up to a judder bar. Here we go. Now remember.
Careful.
Got to take care of.
Fast.
Oh. What? I just heard a clank come from it. Oh well, here's another one. Here we go. Oh, Penny Rabbit. Oh shit.
Holy crap.
It wasn't knackered before, it certainly is now. I mean, and this is residential, right? This is a residential area of where I live. I mean, you're pottering along here at a very little speed. But we have to ask ourselves, what kind of person would actually buy a Hyundai Getz over its competition. Because, well, here's the thing. I was saying to myself, when I was driving this car home from the rental place, I said to myself, well, it's got an excuse. It's a cheap car. It'll be the lowest of the low, you know. It's going to be a very cheap little vehicle because it's you know, an economy car. Let's face it, you know, affording a new car is a tough thing. And really, if you want a new car, sometimes you have to go for the basic end of things. So I thought to myself, the Hyundai Getz is fine because it'll be a little $12,000 car or less. And, you know, yeah, Alex is laughing because he knows what's coming. No, ladies and gentlemen, in New Zealand, a basic Hyundai Getz is $1,000 more than a Suzuki Swift mid-range model. It's $1,000 more, you get a smaller engine, less power, worse fuel economy, less airbags, plastic wheels instead of alloys, plastic trim instead of a full metal body. Sorry, why would you buy it?
Yeah, it's not very practical.
Come on, you bitch! Jesus! See, and then it doesn't know what gear it's in. Did you hear it going, and drop? So, now we're on a bit more difficult territory. We're on a sort of a, you might want to film yourselves. We're on sort of a, you might want to film. We're on sort of a, it looks like a bit of a backcountry road, so let's test the handling. Yeah, that's absolutely shocking. There's clanging coming from it. The ESP lights come on for no reason at all. I'm doing 60 kilometres an hour. I feel like the whole thing's about to explode. The engine's labouring at 2,000 RPM. There's another bump in the road. The suspension is absolutely shocking. And look, I know you get the impression now, oh, I really must hate this car. It's because it's a heap of junk. And because you can buy a plenty better car for less money. You can buy a Suzuki Swift basic model, which has more airbags and a better engine and better fuel economy, for $17,500. A basic one of these is $23,000. I mean, where does Hyundai get off charging so much for this car?
It's not a very good marketing technique. Oh, damn.
Okay, doing about 80 now.
Oh good lord.
Okay, so we'll slow down for this hill.
Oh, my mind.
We'll slow down for this hill. So we're now doing about, and let's put the power on. That's foot flat to the floor.
Oh my, it's a testament to how s**t this car is.
Jesus, why are we behind this man in this? Oh, it's another Hyundai, it's an Accent!
Hyundai!
What is he towing with it? Film this. Look at this man, look at this stupid man. This is a man who said, I want to spend more than I spent on a Japanese car, so I can buy a Korean car and tow stuff.
Is that foot down? All the way down?
Yep, that's flat.
My. About to explode.
It's that's labouring the whole time. That's brakes.
Yeah.
At this point, we'd lost hope, but maybe the Hyundai Getz was hiding something from us. So we decided to see if it was any good off road. It wasn't. So we gave up. Well, we finished our road test of the Hyundai Getz. It's appalling. Now my house is that way, about 2 kilometres. And to be bluntly honest with you, it's forest, and I'm going to get carved up walking through there, and I'll probably tear my nice Barker's sweatshirt. I don't care. I'd rather walk. There you go, Alex. See you, mate. As you probably just noticed while setting up for the shop, this lovely doggy here, I don't even know his name or anything, he came from that house.
I'll call him Chester.
Started sniffing around here. You know how a dog does when it decides it wants to relieve itself? It has a sniff and then does its business. So this dog, Chester, we shall call him, was sniffing around the Getz. And then he decided that wasn't good enough for him, so he went over there and did it in that bush. So there's a solution. Don't buy a Hyundai Getz, buy a bush.